My name is Mustafa Zuhair Mahmoud. I am a radiology and ultrasonography professor and consultant. This lecture series will cover ultrasound physics and instrumentation. In lecture number one, I will begin by discussing the fundamentals of ultrasound physics. Let us begin with an introduction. In this introduction, I would like to state that the very word physics can be intimidating to many. However, no matter how you feel about the subject, you can rest assured we are going to get through it. I'm not saying it will be all fun and games, but we will make it through, one step at a time. Moreover, who knows, it might even be just a little bit of fun. Our lecture will cover the six topics listed below, which are presented to you in the current slide as units, units conversion, nature of sound, sound spectrum, types of waves, and acoustic variables. So, let us begin by discussing the term units. In term of units, all numerical values must have corresponding units. Why? Because units give numbers meaning. Furthermore, a unit is a fixed quantity used as a unit of measurement. You are probably already familiar with the following units: units of length, units of area, units of volume, units of time, and units of speed. In addition, the viewer can return to slide 7 and 8 to see detailed examples of the units of length, area, volume, time, and speed. This slide contains more information about the International System of Units. To be more specific, the International System of Units is the modern version of the metric system and the most widely used system of measurement. I now move on to the second topic of this lecture, units conversion. The most important things to remember when converting units are: number one, am I converting from a small to a larger unit or vice versa? Number two, how much of a conversion factor is there? Then, divide by the conversion factor if the conversion unit is larger. Either multiply by the conversion factor if the conversion unit is smaller. You can now solve the following exercise question as a practical application to explain what was previously mentioned about the unit's conversion mechanism, and the answers are attached after this slide. You can now see how accurate your answers were to the previous exercise questions. More discussion of unit's conversion with examples is available on this slide as well. Let us now turn our attention to the third point of this lecture, which is about the nature of sound. Sound is mechanical energy transmitted by pressure waves in a medium, according to the definition. As you can see, I have put a line under two words to help you understand the definition. Mechanical energy and waves are the two words. Based on the foregoing and for clarification, energy is the capacity to do work. Mechanical means that energy exists as physical movement of molecules and particles in the medium. A wave is the disturbance or variation that transfers energy progressively from one point to another in a medium. The fourth point in today's lecture is the sound spectrum. A sound spectrum displays the different frequencies present in a sound. So, audible sound is defined as sound waves with frequencies ranging from 20 Hz to 20 kHz. Ultrasound is defined as sound waves with a frequency greater than 20 kHz. And infrasound refers to sound waves with frequencies less than 20 Hz. Please take note of the attached image, which depicts the frequency range with which ultrasound is used medically in the field of medical ultrasound diagnostics. In addition, please take note of the following remarks. Human ears cannot hear infrared sound, but it can be felt as vibrations. The range of audibility is another name for audible frequencies. The primary application of ultrasound is in medical diagnosis. The topic appears before the last topic, which is about the type of waves on slide 21 of this lecture. When discussing wave types, it's important to remember that electromagnetic radiation, for example, X-rays, radio waves, and light, travels as transverse waves. The displacement of particle in this type of waveform is perpendicular to or 90 degrees to the direction of wave travel, as shown in the image below. Furthermore, sound waves travel in the form of longitudinal waves. The displacement of particles in this type of wave is in the same direction, parallel, as the movement of the wave energy, as shown in the corresponding image. We can now confidently answer the question on the screen. What is sound? We are confident that our response will be as follows. Sound is a mechanical wave. Sound is a longitudinal wave. Sound is a type of pressure wave. Sound is a form of energy. Sound is not ionizing radiation. Sound is not a transverse wave. Sound is not an electromagnetic wave. The final section of this lecture will go over the acoustic variables. Acoustic variables, in fact, describe the events that occur in sound waves. Acoustic variables are quantities such as pressure, density, temperature, and particle motion. These quantities are defined as follows. Pressure is the concentration of force or force over a specific area. The concentration of mass or weight is defined as density. The concentration of heat energy is defined as temperature. Finally, particle motion includes a particle's displacement, speed, velocity, and acceleration. You can also take note of the units that go with each of the quantities I just mentioned. Please like and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to receive notifications of new video updates. Okay, see you later. Thanks.